Welcome back. It is Saturday, January 7th in the NBA. My two favorite picks are on the way. Let's recap yesterday. A 2-3 day. Julius Randle and Westbrook both get it done. DeMar does not. Our best bet of the day. Kyrie Irving goes like 7-23. And then Tyrese Haliburton, our added play of the day, comes about two or three PRAs short. Back-to-back losing days for the first time in nearly a month. The fellas, let's be honest, they just didn't get done. And look, we're going to have losing days here and there. It's going to happen. My record speaks for itself. We obviously have a lot more winning days than losing days, but losing days is a part of being a sports bettor, just part of the game. And hopefully we can bounce back today and cut this little mini losing streak down. Look, if you are new, my name's Austin. We do these videos every morning. Go hit that subscribe button. Trying to hit 70,000 subscribers one of these days. Also, drop a like too. Comment your favorite picks down below. Since it is Saturday, there are a couple NFL games on today. I posted my favorite picks for that video. We have a player prop, a ladder play. I like it even better. And then we have a spread pick in that video. It was posted last night. I'll link it, obviously, at the bottom of, in the description, comment section. You'll be able to find it. Just go check our video. It's the most recent video posted. Let's drop into our favorite picks of the day, though. My best bet of the day, DeMar DeRozan, under 0.5 props given on this show until post all-star break. Throw 1,000 units on that. I ain't taking no more DeMar DeRozan props unless something changes on the Spurs team. This is obviously joking. Obviously DeRozan didn't come through yesterday, but feels like DeMar DeRozan, we never can predict when he's going to play well. I can guarantee you he plays well today and hits his over in points, but I will not be on it because, look, I could have some more colorful words about Mr. DeRozan, but we need to keep these videos monetized. Let's hop into our favorite picks, though. The best bet of the day segment is going to get the weekend off. I don't love today's slate. Today's slate has a lot of teams that I really don't like betting on, and there will be no added plays today. So two plays today. That's all we're going to do. Let's go 2-0, and let's move into tomorrow, which we went when we have 9 games on. Let's hop into this first one. Jordan Clarkson. I like his over 22.5 points minus 112 on Barstool. I played this up to 23.5. If this goes, and the COS All-Stars, and the community has been raising props like crazy, if this goes to 24.5, please do not bet that. It's not worth betting 24.5. 22.5, 23.5 is fine because, you know, Clarkson's flirting around this line. You'll see what I mean. Last 9 games, averaged 22.7 points per game. I'll put up all the points he scored in the last 9. 19 plus in all of them. 21, 22, 22, then 23, 23, 24, 25, 25. Look, no reason to bet if it goes up to 24.5. 23.5, I'd probably still play at one. I'd maybe half a unit, maybe, you know, 1 unit. I think he can get that. I like his matchup today, but betting 24.5 points for Clarkson, nah, it couldn't be me. But I think Clarkson can easily get us 22.5, hopefully 23.5. 24.5, just a little bit too high. Let's talk about Clarkson, though, as he's taking on Chicago in Chicago, and I expect them to deploy Patrick Williams, a great defender, on Lauri Markkanen. Look, Markkanen is on a heater. I know everyone's going to be giving out his over in points plus rebounds, and I can't blame him. Problem is, I don't like being on props where every single person is on it. We saw that happen 2 days ago when everyone was on Jason Tatum's over. What did he do? Finish on the hook for everyone. And while I expect the Bulls, they're not the greatest defense, they're going to at least put a lot of attention towards Markkanen, who already abused him earlier this year for like 34 points. In that game, Clarkson only scored 8 points. But over these last, you know, 9 games, he's attempted 16.1 field goal attempts per game, 5.7 free throw attempts, and Clarkson never seen a shot he did not like. And that's what we love to see, because Chicago has been getting abused by shooting guards this year. In fact, they're allowing the second most three-pointers made in the league, second highest three-point percentage, and Clarkson, a very solid shooter, and he's going to be out there for 30 or more minutes, attempting a lot of threes. The last 30 games, Bulls, 6th most points per game to shooting guards, second most 3 points per game to shooting guards. So they've been getting abused by shooting guards. We saw Tyrese Maxey, a guy that obviously isn't necessarily the main ball handler for his team. He scored 26 last night and only like 15 shot attempts. Hopefully Clarkson gets closer to, you know, 17, 20 shot attempts. He's obviously, if he gets hot, he's going to keep shooting. And I think he certainly has a great matchup here. I don't necessarily know who's going to guard him from the Bulls, but I know it's not going to be Patrick Williams, their best defender. And I think he could get Zach LaVine. I think he has a pretty decent night. The over-under, 235.5, to still down Colin Sexton. So Schiltz will see his shots. Hopefully Clarkson can just score. Hopefully he can score 25 or more points just to get everyone's line out of the way. But I have faith in him. Over 22.5 points. Just 1 unit on it. No best bet of the day here. And then my second play, I was looking at that Dallas Mavericks game, and I have a guy I really like. I had to decide between Christian Wood or this guy. And I went with this guy, Tim Hardaway Jr., over 15.5 points, minus 120 on Barstool. This should probably go up to 16.5. Don't play it at 17.5. I don't think 17.5 is a line that Tim Hardaway Jr. should get. I think 16.5 is about as high as I would go. And let's talk about him. If you get to 17.5, I'd probably same game parlay like 15 points and 1 or 2 threes, because Tim Hardaway Jr. is not getting to, you know, 20 points if he's not making a lot of threes. And let's talk about him and the Mavericks at home taking on the Pelicans. Now, Mavericks coming off a blowout loss that we saw on TNT a couple nights ago to the Celtics. They should play better today, and including Luka Doncic, who is probable. Now, there's always a chance, we've seen the NBA, where players are probable, then randomly they don't play. So if Luka doesn't play, that'd be great, obviously, for Tim Hardaway Jr., but we expect Luka to be out there. Now, Hardaway Jr. coming off a bad game in that game, like the whole Mavericks team, only 8 points, 2 for 11 shooting, but he still played 36 minutes. It was still a blot. He still got his minutes, and I think he continues to get his minutes because this is a Mavericks team that is shorthanded. Dorian Finney-Smith out, Josh Green out, Maxi Kleber out. All these guys, they're short on wings. They need THJ out there, and we've had some good luck with guys with juniors in their last name. At least Kevin Porter Jr. treated us nice a couple games ago. But look, Tim Hardaway Jr., like Jordan Clarkson, never seen a shot he did not like. He's going to keep firing it up in his last 8 games, all of them without Dorian Finney-Smith, DFS. He's averaged 15.8 points per game, scoring 16 plus in 4 of 8 games. Now, he's averaging 13.6 field goal attempts. So he's nearly averaging this line and just shot attempts. And I think he could get closer to 15 today. And Hardaway played 36.7 minutes per game in all those games, attempting 11 or more shots in all 8. So he's still going to be out there shooting a lot. I think there'll be some transition in this game against the Pelicans. And Hardaway, always a great candidate for bounce backs. What do I mean by that? Well, you look at over this 8 game stretch, obviously he's gone under in 4 of them, the 4th being the most recent game. The previous 3 games, bounce back the next game, scoring 26, 18, and 21 points. Look, the Pelicans are going to put everyone they got. This is a big-time game, and these guys in the same conference, big game, they're going to throw everyone they can at Luka Doncic, make other guys beat him. And you look at a guy like Tim Hardaway Jr., played well versus this team in the past. In fact, his last 5 against them, 12, 16, 17, 27, and 30 points. All of those games playing less than 35 minutes. Obviously, he's playing well over that kind of recently. He's over this line in 10 of 16 games this year with 30 or more minutes. You should easily see 30 or more minutes, even if it is a blowout. I think Tim Hardaway Jr. plays a lot better. They're back at home again, where he shoots a little bit better. I like THJ to have a pretty big game. We'll take us over 15.5 points. Like I said, 16.5 is fine. If it goes up to 17.5, just wait. It's going to get bet down to 16.5. It should not be 17.5. Go THJ. I could force some more plays, but honestly, the slate's not great. There's 9 games on tomorrow. Let's wait for that slate. We don't need to try to win all of our units back. That's not how you win money long-term, is trying to win units back. Just take it with day by day. We're going to only play 2 plays. Hopefully go 2-0, win back about 2 units, and we'll move on to tomorrow. It's time to shout out your favorite part of the video. Time to shout out some COS All-Stars. And I got to say, you guys have been absolutely crushing the support. I never expected to be reading this list. I thought this would be our full list ever. The fact that this is just new All-Stars in the last day is ridiculous. But if you want to become an All-Star, go click the join button down below. You get our plays a little bit early, which recently that's been crucial because the lines are changing like crazy. But either way, or maybe we'll switch up how we do that. I don't really know. But either way, you'll still get the plays early regardless. Might be a different way we do it. Let's move in and let's talk about them. Enrique, OT Well 420. We got Most Vuno. We got Jack, Anthony, Scoofy TV, Johnny. We got Krishna, Juan, Carlos, Marvin, Chris, Jack, M-E-R, Michael, Levi, KS, Adam, Chris, Six High, Jamie, Elliot, Don, The Williams Boys, Will, Kevin, Joe Carly, Garrett, Messiah of Love, Jaquan, Gavin, Brown. We got Todd, Tadaz, Jay Holly, Travis, Mike, Go Sixers, Go. That was not a great night for you. Kyle, Omar, Jordan, Davis, Daniel, Roberto, Blue Duck. We got Daryl, Patrick, Victor, Brian, Honest D. We got Hunter, Marcus, Quicksand, Brian, Scott, Dylan, Timmy, Green, Grass, That's Pads, That Way Fam, Charlie, Jordy, I don't know, Cool Man, Dion Allen, Lefty Pauly, we got Carrington, Ethan, Ben, Kuba, Pete. Like I said, you guys can see, you guys have been crushing the support. I don't even know how far I still have a lot more. Let's go. I don't know where I stopped off. Kuba, P, Ben, Jeremiah, Ross, Mark, Harold, Alex, Roberto, Carson, Wes, Chris, Quindarian, Brandon, Joe King, Slick Rick, we got William, Justin, Mitch, Pedro, K, The Great, John, Paul, we got Sam, Spencer, my cat's outside meowing, Logan, Ivan, we got Richie, Tanner, Darren, Steven, we got Tyler, Daly, Daniel, Antonio, 072, Garage, Sharon, Young Dave, Artie, B-Man, 5422, Saksham, Chase, Jack, Christopher, Weeb, we got Jamie, GGWP, we got Jameson, MLB, 10523, Ronnie, Michael, Jacob, Jack, Ronnie, JC, Chris, Damari, Brian, 1.5 billion inches, the whole, I don't know what that, I'm not even going to dive into that name, the Holloman, Tegan, Mike will do, Derek, Dre, we got DFS and Donuts, Heather, Aaron, number 58, Brandon, Viswanth, Patrick, Antonio Brown, whatever, he's partnered with Fliff, I guess he doesn't care, Astros, Brian, Johnny, Tyler, Forrest, Rick Flair, Lons, Josh, Claire, Steven, Carl, Pat, Jesp, Simon, Ryan, G, Rego, Pell State Picks, Adam, Michael, Carlos, Kyle, Tim, Kyle again, Lando, Sam, Alec, Anthony, King Tay, Jova, Xavier, and Robert. You guys have been crushing the sport. We appreciate you guys so much. We can't do without you guys. Look, if you want to become an all-star, click the join button down below. That NFL picks video, I'll put it right here. Go check it out. It's right there, my two favorite picks for Saturday. I'll have another video live later on today with my Sunday picks. Stay tuned for that. See you guys back in the next one. Let's have a 2-0 day. We need 2-0. See you guys later. Peace.